Welcome to MCN and our series of videos where I talk to my MCN colleagues about the bikes they've been running in 2021, our long-term test bikes. Now, with my road tester's hat on, I can tell you all about what these bikes are like when they're new, how they handle, all that kind of stuff. But the job of our long-term testers is to do big miles on the bikes, live with them and see if any problems arise, see if they enjoy them or not. And today we're talking about the Moto Guzzi V7. I've ridden this lots of times in the past and really, really like it. We've been privileged enough to go to the factory on Lake Como. You know, you've got all the emotion of the bikes. They're lovely to ride. But we haven't really run one as a long-term test bike for a very, very long time. And this year, I'm glad to say we have. And Saffron's been running the Guzzi. So welcome to our little studio here. It's a little bit of background noise there, making a conservatory next door. But back to the bike. So tell me a little bit about, first of all, your riding experience to get a flavour of where this bike kind of rates in the bikes you've had before.
Okay, well, I'm quite new to MCN. So I've only been here since April. So how long is that now?
Where are we now? Almost November.
Yeah, so yeah. I've only been here since then. Yeah. But before that, I have been riding since I was 16. So I got a moped. And then as soon as I could, I got a 125, which was a Suzuki Marauder, I think. Then after that, I had a couple of Kawasaki's. I had an ER5 and then a ZR7. But more recently, and what I'd saved up for was my Harley Davidson Heritage Softail. So very big, very bulky, yeah. Very heavy, very comfortable.
Yeah.
And then I came here and jumped on this for my long-term test.
Right. So would you say it's quite different to what you're used to?
Absolutely, yeah. Yeah, I'm quite used to a turning circle of the moon. And I'm quite used to having to kind of fight in traffic because it's quite heavy and it's quite lumbered and yeah. Stuff like that. But this, it's made for the city. That's what they say anyway.
Yeah.
So it's very different because this I feel like I could throw around more like a, it felt like a 125 because it was just so different to what I'm used to.
Yeah, yeah.
Which was really, really nice because it was so different and it was so easy to ride and things like that.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
You wouldn't necessarily equate a Moto Guzzi of being quite light and nimble, but it is, isn't it?
In comparison, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So how long have you had it and what kind of miles have you done in it? Where have you been?
So I got it in August, towards the end of August. So I've only had it for about 4 months, but I've managed to get 3,000 miles on the clock.
Wow.
So that's involved going up to Blackburn in the rain constantly. It involved going down to Cornwall in the rain constantly. I've also been down to the South Coast and I've been up to down to Swindon, up to Ripon. Yeah, a couple of different places really. Wanted to get the most out of it really.
Yeah, so. A lot of miles. So let's sort of dig down into some specifics. This is the stone edition, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
What does that mean?
Bog standard, basically. You don't get any okay. of the extra fancy features. This is your entry level.
Yeah. And what about sort of the finish of it and the kind of durability so far? Obviously, it's relatively new, but you've done a lot of miles. You've probably done at least a year's worth of a regular rider's miles,
yeah.
haven't you?
So yeah.
How's it standing up?
Well, firstly, when I got it, there was a couple of scratches just because it had been used before, right. not for a few miles. So I don't know what happened there. But overall, I really like the matte finish and the bright orange, just because it completely stands out with the crowd.
Yeah.
But after using it more frequently and going through cities and maybe gravelly paths, there has been a couple of instances of stone chips on the exhaust.
Oh yes, yeah, so it's a matte satin finish, isn't it?
Yeah,
so,
yeah. So they've come up quite obviously.
Yeah.
In comparison. Otherwise, the matte on the tank seems to be holding up pretty good.
Yeah.
But it's
a nice
mainly,
finish, that.
Yeah, it's lovely. It's absolutely lovely. So yeah, I guess it was just the stone chips on the exhausts, I would say, was the biggest point. Everything else seems to be all right at the moment, but again, because it's all matte, that could change.
Yeah.
Depending on how long you exactly. ride for, through the winter or anything like that.
And what about its reliability? All good?
Well, a couple of things. A couple of things have gone wrong, but equally, it's always started. I can't complain with that. It's always started. Couple of niggles though, just because you've got that V-twin, which gives you a bit of a vibration, kind of chugs you from side to side a little bit, and you've got your potholes and you've got your gravel and all that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
Things are loosening up and they're doing it a bit quicker than I would have expected it to. So for example, the gears, getting into neutral and first was really, really difficult, but it turns out it's because the clutch had got loose.
Yeah, the adjuster.
Which we just fixed, yep. And the other thing was, I did have a mirror go loose. Again, kind of expected that. It happens everywhere.
Yeah.
But the other thing was the headlight. I was coming back from Cornwall, and when it got to 8 o'clock and it got dark, I turned the headlight on, and I could only see 6 foot in front of me, so I couldn't see anything. So took it to go and get adjusted, but we found that it's actually because it's completely tight, it's the right torque strength, everything like that, but the actual whole headlight moves.
This.
Yeah, and it can be moved quite easily.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's not great, is it?
So I'm assuming the more miles you do, the more vibrations you have, that's always going to start moving down. And so you're always going to have to push that back up. It's just one of those things you've got to live with, I think.
Are they LEDs, are they?
Yeah, LEDs, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so the actual light itself, really bright, really good.
But it just doesn't point where you want it.
No. Didn't at the time. And of course, I didn't know about that at the time, so it was an interesting ride home.
Quite ahead of its time, because I think my BMW's got adaptive headlights and it goes up and down.
Mm.
So there you go, you've got that for free.
Oh, there you go. Wish I knew that on the way home.
So it's quite, this bike's all about style, isn't it? Mm. So do you like the style of it? Is it your cup of tea?
Yeah, I've got a bit of a soft spot for a retro. So I really, really like it. The other thing is, I've stopped at quite a few different places, and every time I've stopped, I've got a crowd around them.
Yeah.
If I'm at a petrol station, I've gone in to pay, I'll come back and there's three people having a look
and just
talking about it and asking me about it and things like that. So definitely gets the attention, and I think it should, because it looks absolutely amazing, and it's just got that Moto Guzzi styling that kind of sets it apart from everything else.
Yeah, yeah. And is it, you said it's quite light, it's quite comfortable, is it?
Mm. The only thing that isn't really retro is the seat, because you haven't got the normal kind of straight seat that you'd normally expect. But the scoop on it makes such a difference. It's so comfortable.
Yeah.
Like I said, I could be on it for 16 hours. And because you've got the scoop, and because you're a bit more upright, you're not quite over the tank, you're still quite comfortable after a really long ride.
Yeah.
Surprising for a naked, and you've got nothing on the fairing or anything like that. So yeah, really, really comfortable. I'd really rate it.
What about the performance of it? How does it handle? How does it go?
Unlike the other V7s, it's actually an 850. I believe it's because it's the 100th year anniversary. Might be wrong. But with that little bit of extra power, it's got a lot more grunt. And it's really sensitive to a throttle. It accelerates really quickly, again, which I was surprised at, considering looking at the bike. And you kind of, it's just a nice ride, it's a nice smooth ride, and you're not put off by the pistons going the opposite way or anything like that. And,
or the shaft drive.
Or the shaft drive, yeah. Yep.
So it's got a bit of character.
Yeah.
It's still quite refined, aren't they?
Absolutely.
Yeah. It's come a long way. And what about the handling of it? Do you feel confidence inspiring? Good brakes, good tyres?
Well, yeah, I will say that. I did a road track day. So I went with rapid training and on a track to kind of learn some road skills. And I was on there for all day and pushing the brakes really hard and pushing the throttle really hard, and no brake fade. And I still felt confident, and the confidence only got better throughout the day as I learnt more techniques. So I will say it could handle that. So you should be fine on road.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So is there anything you don't like about it, or anything you'd want to change?
So something I particularly don't like, apart from maybe just the little, I kind of expected it to just kind of hold out a bit more with the clutch and things like that. For me personally, I do a few more miles, so I think I'll probably pop on a screen, just a little one, just to kind of get a bit more wind off me.
Yeah.
And I'll probably put on a rack, just because at the moment I'm having to strap to the...
Like the subframe.
The subframe, yep. Yeah. Which is awkward, because you have to take the seat off every time and stuff that. And then, of course, because it's the stone, you don't get all, you haven't got all the fancy electrics or anything like that. So I kind of miss cruise control and things like that, which would be really nice for a modern bike.
But just
little bits, I think, just to make my life a little bit more easy.
Does it have any rider aids? ABS, obviously.
It's got ABS. It has got traction control.
Has it ever chimed in?
No.
So it's got a nut, so the engine's friendly, the tyres are grippy, so it doesn't really need it, but it's there just in case.
Yeah, absolutely.
So would you buy one? That's the big question. You've lived with it now for enough time to get to know it.
I don't know. I don't feel like I have. It's only been four months.
One more, yeah.
Yeah. So I'm not sure whether I would, just because I haven't fallen in love with it.
Yeah.
And when I get a bike, I have to be really excited about getting on it every day. And that has happened, but I haven't. basically I'm going to give it back, but I'm not overly fussed about giving it back, which, you know, if it was like my own bike, I think I would be.
What do you think's missing?
I'm not really sure. It's just, it just hasn't got the heart.
Yeah.
I don't think.
I think it's too refined, maybe.
Maybe you need a little bit more clunkiness, a little bit more retroness, just to kind of make a bit of a difference.
That's interesting.
Yeah, but again, that's just me. Might be completely different for other people.
Yeah.
But yeah, it hasn't grabbed me as much as I thought it would.
Yeah. I think a lot of manufacturers want to make their bikes smoother and more refined and easier, but by doing that, they do take away some character, don't they?
Absolutely.
Well, that's brilliant. Well, thanks very much for taking me through your baby. It's going to go back very soon, isn't it?
Yeah. Unfortunately.
Cool. Thank you very much. Well, thanks very much for watching, and stay tuned for more of our long-term test videos soon.